Praise the living God. Thank you for joining me again today, dear heart, on Call In Deliverance Live Radio for July 4th, 2018. Now remember, if you need a prayer and deliverance, come and join your faith with my faith for your total deliverance in Christ Jesus' mighty name. Now we hold Shalom morning prayer. That's where we get together to pray corporately in Jesus' name according to the will of the Holy Spirit. For that is where the Holy Spirit prays. That's every Tuesday morning at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Now, the call-in deliverance is held every Wednesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So be sure to come expecting. Remember, all calls are public, recorded, and shared on all our programs. And you can visit the website for more detail on how to join the call. It's best to go to the website, radio.evangelistking.me. That way you always be updated on our upcoming episodes. And also be sure to follow me on my Blog Talk radio program, which is held at, well, which is found at blogtalkradio.com/longprayerandDeliverance. And you can follow me there. That way you also will be updated on our upcoming episode. But it's also mainly best to go to the website, radio.evangelistking.me. That way, you know, you can see the upcoming episode, and it might be, I might not be able to do a particular schedule episode, then you will be notified on the website. Praise the living God. Now remember, dear heart, when we come to Jesus Christ, we must be willing to give up our reputation. Just as he given up his reputation, as I mentioned on our Shalom morning prayer on yesterday, we must be willing to give up our reputation. We cannot hold that. If the Holy Spirit brought a certain memory back to your remembrance, but the Holy Spirit wants you to confess that, because that's the open door in which the enemy is holding not to leave you. You know, when the enemy is found out, he knows he must go in Jesus' name. And you know, dear heart, Jesus Christ wants all of us, not just us serving him in our spirit, but also serving him in our mind, will, emotions, in our body. And most of his children never been delivered, because we were taught once we come to him, everything about us is saved, when it's not true. It's our spirit that's birthed one to the family of God. And those devils are still living in the soul realm, the mind, will, emotion, and the body. And that's why Jesus dedicated his authority to his body on earth, those who have his Holy Spirit living, ruling, reigning within them, and believe in the name of Jesus Christ. He had delegated his authority and power over all the power of the enemy and commanded them to come out of a person's soul and out of their body in Jesus' mighty name. And therefore, everybody's not anointed as they have stated. Everybody is not. So you have to ask the Lord to send you to your human helper. I praise and thank him for sending me to mine. Glory to his holy name. Well, see, I do have some callers on this 4th of July holiday. Well, I see someone's calling from the UK. So I usually like bringing in my international first, since there's a vast tide difference. And then I bring in the next caller, Grace God. So I'm going to unmute the UK. Give me your first name in the state you're calling from. I'm sorry, I already know the country. So just give me your first name. Give me your first name in the state you're calling from. Now, if you are hearing me, I'm hearing a lot of background noise, but I'm not hearing you. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Okay. Okay, hello. Let me have your first name.
Elizabeth.
Okay, so this is Elizabeth that called in for Shalom morning prayer.
Elizabeth.
Okay, Elizabeth. All right. Okay, so Elizabeth, you are the one who called in to Shalom morning prayer yesterday.
Yes, I'm the same person.
Okay, I want to make sure, because I was expecting your call, so I want to mark your name out. Okay, how did you find out about it?
I think it's a long story, but I think it's the Holy Ghost that sent me to you. I resisted to call, but later on I realized that was the Holy Ghost that was asking me to call you. This was last week, 10 days ago, actually.
Okay, you found out about me, did you say years ago?
No, it was 10 days ago. I've been praying for help. I think Holy Ghost sent me the website. No, 10 days ago. 10
years.
10 days ago.
10 days ago, you were praying, asking Lord for help.
Yeah. I was asking the Lord for help. So I think it took me to his website I normally go to. Then it took me to his place I've never been to. Then I found your prayer there, which was unusual to me. But I neglected it. So I was making the same prayer, the same request to him. Then later, he took me back to that same place, and he focused my attention on you again. But when I click it up,
wow.
I must be sincerely, I refused to call because I was so scared. And then I neglected the whole thing. Then I continued making the prayer. Then I realized there was something wrong because my prayer wasn't answered, and he wasn't speaking to me any longer. So on the 25th, I went there and I boldly said, okay, I'll give it a try. And I was closing my ears and closing one eye, and I pressed the button play. So I was playing Jadeen Deliverance. Immediately, I realized something, that there was peace in me. Then I realized that the actually it was the Holy Ghost that sent me there. But still, I resisted everything. I refused to proceed because I don't know why. There was a strong fear in me, and I refused. And after some few days, the Holy Ghost put pressure on me and tried to speak to my heart. And I went back there, and I started watching your videos, following your teachings, and I found them very, very useful. I went through most of your videos, the ones you did when you initially... You know, you initially started when you went to the prayer, meeting, when you met, I think 10 years, 1994, when you met the girl that was having demons inside her, and you tried to pray for her, and you realized that there was something wrong, that you couldn't do anything because you lacked something. I mean, you weren't having the power of the Holy Ghost, then you started doing all your process to understand what was happening in your prayer life. And, you know, I went through most of your recent video. I went through them. I went through your family history. I went through some of the videos you did in the Holy Ghost. It was a hard teaching, but I think it was very useful.
You just checked everything out.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Yeah.
But that resistance, Elizabeth, that resistance was nobody but that spirit husband.
No. I know. I just realized that it was just a one thing after another that was postponing the whole thing. I said, can't just be so. I've been praying for the same. I know there's something going on because most things are very unusual. And when I played Jadeen Deliverance, which was, I think, 10 minutes, I felt peace inside my soul. And I said, it's so unusual. You know, when you feel peace, that means there is the presence of the Holy Ghost there. But there was this fear in me that pay attention, the spirit something, you know, focused my attention on different things, which he knows I'm afraid about. You know, he focused my attention on the hand, the Holy Ghost hand. He focused my attention on the cross. It brings into my memory, you know, terrible things. And I say, it can't just be. The first thing he did was the cross. I said, okay. So I said, I prayed instantly. I said, okay, if it's from Catholic Church, because he was saying, don't go there, it's a Catholic Church. I said, if it's for a Catholic Church, she wouldn't be a woman, because Catholic Church don't accept women.
The Lord told me the devil was telling people my knowledge.
It was the knowledge of Holy Ghost. So it was a very, I can't just really explain the whole thing to you, but it was a very tough battle. Well,
that lion's round.
Yeah, no, just don't want to leave. Absolutely.
The spirits do not want to leave. You know, the Lord told me, because I carried this cross to remind the devil of our legal rights and his illegal right in holding on to us, that he was telling these people I was of the Catholic Church.
Yeah, that was to me. He said, pay attention, you know, Catholic Church, this thing. And don't go there because that's a Catholic Church. Then I prayed, and the Holy Ghost gave me an instant reply. He said, you see, if it's a Catholic Church, she wouldn't be a woman. And I said, thank you, Lord. Then brought out.
Because they do not ordain women.
Mom, you can't just really understand the battle. You can't reach with a tough battle. Every time it brings out new things. I was trying to watch a video which the Holy Ghost was trying to point on me, but you can't believe it that anytime I press on it, it will bring out something else. And I'm talking about the one of Chimay, which I was really interested to watch that one.
Chimay.
Uh-huh. For 4 days, 4 good days, each time I press the button on my computer, it comes out something different.
Mm-hmm.
Until the day I accepted, no, I'm going to go for it. Okay? Then when I just press the button, I ask forgiveness to the Holy Ghost for my fear and my disobedience. I ask forgiveness to God to forgive me for my sin. Then when I press the button, everything just went. Then I watch that video. Mm-hmm. I watch others. I watch your teaching. If I can say something else, when I was watching the first teaching on your personal history, your personal story, you know, how you came across to the Holy Ghost, and so when you were mentioning books of good books that the Holy Ghost told you to go and read, so you mentioned several books. So I wrote down the book's name. Then in the spirit told me, you go and look. Those people, they are fake preachers. Don't go there. Don't read those books.
That's the devil.
That's what he said to me. Yeah, that's the devil. He said, don't read. He said that person, which was John Austin, he said he's a fake preacher. Yeah, his son is a fake preacher. If you type in the internet like this, you'll see he's a fake preacher.
But which
I
did,
I went to check out. It was the people in the website, they said he was a fake preacher, something like that. But I went to get the book which you made mention of, and I read the book. And I was, you know, the book was very useful because I happened to know I realized part of my mistakes, you know. And again, there was one after another, several things coming out, and it was a long battle. But my main focus now is that Jesus won, and glory be to Jesus. You know, I'm very, very, I'm very happy. I'm happy.
You will get delivered today from those spirits.
I wish to. If it's the desire of
God. It's the will of God. But just the reason why Jesus died, for our freedom. Freedom from who? Freedom from these demons that was tossed from that fallen angels that were tossed from heaven on this earth. And their intention to kill, steal, and destroy. That's why he freed us. That was the purpose of the cross. That's why they don't like to be reminded of the cross. Because they know, because of the cross, they don't have legal right to hang on to us. They only can hang on to us if we don't believe that it's the will of the Lord that he set us free. We must receive that finished work that he did on Calvary. It goes like that. That's the truth. And the enemy knows that. But you're going to get set free. Now, this spirit lover, that's all it is a spirit that is claiming to be your lover. Just in the natural, you get a human lover. Well, in the spirit, you had a spirit lover first. And that spirit was a spouse to you when you was a little girl. It tricked you due to the failure of your parents making a covenant with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So that was the open door ground in which they had legal access into your life as a child. Because the parents are the covering for the children. So if the parent rejects Jesus Christ, well, the child don't have a spiritual covering, who is Jesus Christ? So the spirit espouses itself to you as a little girl, when you're a little girl, and it's known as a molestation. It doesn't mean that you was penetrated as a little girl. That simply means that you came aware of sex, and it wasn't the time. There's a time for all things. And everybody on the line, you listen to what I'm saying, so that way I don't have to repeat myself. That's how you get a spouse to spirit lover. Through that molestation as a child, you came to know about sex, and it really wasn't your time yet. There was a set time for that. Now, in most cases, as a little girl, the little girl could have been fondled, or you could have came across some pornographic material, or you could have heard your parents or someone else having sex, or you could hear you could have seen them, or you could have heard them talk about it. All of that is still known as molestation, Elizabeth. And when that happened, according to how it happened, whether you saw it or whether you heard it, that spirit entered through that opening, through the eye gate and through the ear gate. Okay? What have the Holy Spirit, because the Lord said, he promised me when I make mention of what molestation is and talk about these things, it's the Holy Ghost who will bring back to the person remembrance, a slight memory of what of something that happened. So share that. Don't call out no name.
Yeah.
Don't need to call out no
yeah,
name.
Yeah, yeah. I've been blessed because my process is not just I've been going through this process with the Holy Ghost for a while now, so he has brought to my memories many. But I think
I just need
I think it was when I was a youth, but I can't really say at what age. But we're living in a compound where everything goes, you know, not in I think it was maybe five, six years. I can't really remember at what time, but I know we were very little.
Mm-hmm. And you're living in a compound.
Yeah.
And what happened?
There's this family, there's this man in this family that normally molests children, his own children, other children. I think that was where it happened. They just, you know, kids abuse of children. Oh. Maybe they touch the children.
They were not.
Yeah. That was what really happened. There wasn't. But I understood the way you explained to Nicole. Because I watched the video also of Nicole. So you made a very clear teaching of Nicole about what molestation really means, which I agree personally. Okay, because it's
I had to ask the Lord, because a lot of times when I ask a person, they say, oh, no. And the Lord told me they were thinking about a penetration. So I had to ask the Lord, what is exactly the molestation? And then that's when he gave me that interpretation of it. Because the person figured, they wasn't penetrated, they was not molested. And that's not true.
Yeah. I think I agree with that. I agree with that explanation because, you know, by opening your consciousness about something which was hidden before, it brings, you know, everything unveiled. When it becomes unveiled, your mind starts thinking about that thing. So I think that might be probably a good explanation to say molestation is a way that they come, not necessarily penetration, is a way that, you know, those kind of demons come into somebody's life. So in that case, in my own situation, it was when I was a youth. There wasn't any penetration, but it was then I came across about, you know, things that I wasn't supposed to be. So
it wasn't time yet. It wasn't time. And then what follows is disappointment.
Yeah, I must say the truth. I think I've committed all kind of things in the Bible. I've
gone
against all the Ten Commandments. I'm a sinner.
Right.
I'm a I'm a dirty person, but thank God that Jesus Christ died for me. I'm very, very
right,
dead.
Right. Most important that you
dead.
Gave your life to the Lord, and you sin no more. Sin no more. For God knows
no.
that you're totally free.
No.
But it's up to you to remain
no.
free by sinning no more. Continue to submit to God.
Yeah.
God just need to do His.
Yeah.
God, you need to do your part so God can do His part. Like you heard me say, Lord told me, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. So the Lord now wants to have all of you. So it's time for those demons to vacate. But what I want to ask you, how long have you been serving the Lord? How long have you given your life to the Lord?
My own story, I don't know if you want me to share it, but it's a very strange story.
No, you don't have to share
the
story. I don't have
okay.
much time.
The point is this. I've been living a life exception that was thinking I was really living a righteous life, you know, helping others, doing what pleases God, but without going to church, without reading my Bible, you know, a man-made life. So I was working, working with other people, with poor people, you know, doing what I think was useful for them. But the point there is that there was a deception. I was working actually for the devil. You know, I was leading
okay.
them to the devil because I was saying to them, I'm helping you to get what you need, but actually I'm introducing them to sin. So all these things happened all my lifetime for 20 years when I've been working. Since when 2013, the Lord came into my life because he burst into my life in a very violent way, but thank God he did so because he came
okay.
to the government into my life. So it came to shut down my company, they shut down everything, so I have to just, you know, stop the whole thing. Afterward, introduced somebody which I've never met on the phone to talk to me, to introduce the word of God to me, of which I accepted with a full heart. I've never met the person before. So this person, I told him about my problem, about the company, and I said, if I pray to God, God will step in and God will help me because I was, you know, I might have gone to jail. I must say the truth. So I did so
okay.
in faith. I went to do 21 days fasting. I fasted.
Okay, Elizabeth, I don't have much time, so
yeah.
I can't allow you to
okay.
go on. So all I just need to know,
yeah.
so it was 2013 when you seriously gave
yeah.
your life to the Lord. Okay, 5 years.
I gave my life to the Lord, 2000.
Okay.
I started the process
okay.
in 2014.
14. But you
yeah.
never had an anointed, an appointed servant to confront those demons that took up residence in your soul realm, which is the mind, will, emotion,
no,
your body.
No,
you never,
no.
Okay.
No.
So that's all you need. Those demons got to be kicked out of the house. They're thieves. Just like in the natural, you got thieves in your house. If you can make your way to the phone, call 911, to ask for the arrest and officer to come and bind them, you would do that. Because you, long as they're in your house, you're not free to do what you will to do. And that's what's been happening to you these 4 to 5 years. Those thieves have never been confronted by the arresting officer on this earth. So the arresting officer in the heaven can bind them and kick them out of his house. So I'm about to do that now in Jesus' name. And as the Lord do that, you just continue to submit to the Lord in obedience.
Yeah.
Listen
yeah.
to the voice of the Holy Spirit. You know, it don't matter how quiet he sounds. It don't matter if you don't understand why he asked you not to do such and such. You just do be obedient to him so that you can maintain your deliverance. Because even after your deliverance, these devils are going to try to send other devils to try to get you back. And you can't give in to them. Don't give them no space. Know that Son of God has set you totally free. Just like you called the arresting officer in the natural. Well, you know they're coming to arrest the thief, bound them, and throw them in prison somewhere. And you don't concern yourself about where they went. You don't concern yourself about if they took them out of your house. You know, you believe. Well, the same thing with the Lord. Only difference is you're not going to be able to see when God binds them and arrests them and kick them out. But you got to believe that God has done that. And the Lord does that so that we'll be free to praise and worship our Heavenly Father. Okay?
Amen.
So I'm going to go ahead and pray for you now. And then I'm going to confront. Now, spirit husband is a strong man.
I think it's Leviathan because
don't worry about those other little demons.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
Spirit husband, the strong man. Leviathan served the strong man, spirit husband. All those other demons serve the strong man. Lord said, unless you bind the strong man, you cannot spoil his good.
Okay.
So when by faith in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, bind spirit husband,
okay,
the strong man, all those other little demons under his rulership goes with them. They scatter. They're leaving,
okay,
too. Nobody stays behind. The Lord said nobody stays behind. He kicks them,
okay,
all out, just like he did Legion.
Okay.
He only called out Legion. He didn't call out over 2,000 demon names. He called out Legion because Legion was the strong man. Just like David,
okay,
called out Goliath. Goliath was the strong man. When David killed Goliath, those other little scattered, they ran away. Okay, so don't let these devils fool you and saying, well, she didn't call out my name. I'm here. And she didn't call out my name,
okay,
so I'm still here. That's a lie. They're trying to get you to let them back in. Okay?
Okay.
Praise the living God.
Can I say something? Sorry, can I just say something? Even if I know that they did child dedication to me when I was a youth or before I was born.
Okay, I didn't understand that. Say it again.
I think my parents, they did, they dedicated me to God before I was born.
Don't worry about it, because I'm going to decree the separation from all contracts of grievance in the spirit realm. And when I decree on this earth, my heavenly Father in the heavenly, he will perform it in the heavenly. He disconnect.
Okay.
You will be disconnect from all that. You no longer be under your family lineage, but you'll be under a new covenant agreement of contract, which is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So you don't have to concern yourself with that, because I'm going to do that disconnection by faith.
Amen.
I'm going to pray now.
Amen.
So Father, in Jesus' name again, and as always, I thank you for opportunity to mention your love and mercy and grace to your dear children, especially to your daughter, Elizabeth. Father, I thank you for keeping her mind together, because the enemy really wanted to destroy her mind. Once he destroyed the mind, he would have had everything about Elizabeth. But Father, you did not allow the enemy to take full control of her mind, and we thank you for it. Father, I thank you that you never given up on her. She did not give up on you. I thank you for protecting her all the days of her life. But it's her time now. It's her time to shine bright, Father, and give glory to your Son, Jesus Christ. It's your time to not just have some of her, but to have all of her, Father. It's her time to truly and spiritually worship you, Father. It's her time. And Father, I speak concerning doors. Doors in which the enemy has closed off to Elizabeth. And it's your will for those doors to be open. I take my thoughts in Jesus' name. And I open those doors. And I also close the doors. Close every door that was not the will of God. Let the enemy open. I close those doors in Jesus' name.
And I open them.
Father, we thank you. We glorify you. We magnify you in Jesus' name. Elizabeth.
Yes?
I'm hearing a feedback. I'm hearing feedback. Do you have me on speakerphone? Did you have me on speakerphone? Well, take me off because I hear feed coming back to me. And it don't sound like me. It doesn't sound like what I'm saying. Okay? And I want you to pay attention. Pay attention. Keep your eyes and mind on the Lord, Elizabeth, thanking him for your deliverance, okay? You can't keep your mind on something else while I'm talking, okay? You have to keep your focus on the Lord. Jesus Christ is the deliverer. He's right there with you with his hands, right hand over your head, waiting for me to decree his will to be done on earth. As it is in heaven, he's going to do it. But he can't do it if you keep your mind on other things. You hear me, Elizabeth?
Yes.
Elizabeth? Okay.
Yes, I can hear you. Thank you.
Okay.
Yes.
So again, Father, forgive me for that interruption. But I thank you, Father, for your understanding. And I thank you for hearing me, hearing your word. For you always hear your word. And I thank you that you are faithful. And again, Father, I thank you for your presence with on this call-in deliverance live radio live. For you said when we gather together, even just two of us, in your son's name, you're in the midst. And you also said whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you bind and loose in hell. It doesn't matter to me, Father, who believes your word through me when I speak these words, because I know you are faithful to your word. I know you watches and watches out to hear your word so you can perform it. And your word said, whatever I bind and loose on this earth, you're the one who dies in the heaven. So it's Elizabeth time now. So when she stands before you, she will be excuseless. It's her time now to go forth in the power and the glory and might of your son, Jesus Christ, through the Holy Spirit. And she can't do that with the thieves living in her soul, her mind, her will, emotion, and thieves living in her body. And we thank you for arresting them this day and kicking them out of your house and you sending them where you desire to send them in Jesus' name. So on that note, dear husband, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command you under his authority, the delegated authority, to cut out, you loser mind, turn loser mind, for the blood of Jesus command you to loser mind, loser will, cut her will, looser emotions. Gather all your things and get out of her emotions, her mind, and her will. And gather your load and get out of her body. Out! Get out of her body! Get out of her body! The Spirit of the living God commands you to get out of her body. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost burn every spirit. They're trying to hold on to Elizabeth in her mind. Burn, Holy Ghost, all that is not of you. Ransack her mind by your consuming fire. Go deep down into the conscious and subconscious in the memory of her mind and destroy every image, every picture, negative thing that's been embedded there. Burn it all up. Burn it, Holy Ghost. Continue to ransack her mind. Wash her mind. Clean, rinse, and baptize her mind and fill her mind in and with the blood of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, burn all illegal hands that are trying to hold on to her will. Burn, Holy Ghost, ransack her will by your consuming fire. All that is not of you trying to hold, cling onto her will, burn. Burn all manner of darkness that's holding onto her will. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem, and baptize her will in and with the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, ransackle emotion. Burn every spirit that's trying to hold onto her emotion. Set them all ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn, burn everything in her emotion. They don't look, move, act, or react like you. Set them ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem. Purify her emotion in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, set her body ablaze. Burn all manner of spirit that is still trying to hold onto her body. Set them ablaze, Holy Ghost. Burn spirits that live in her mouth. Set her mouth ablaze. Burn spirits that live in her nose. Set her nose ablaze. Burn spirits that live in her eye. Come up, look out through the window of her eye and set them ablaze. Burn spirits that live in her ears. Set them ablaze. They live in her throat. Set them ablaze. They live in her belly. Set them ablaze. Go deep, deep down in her belly and burn and destroy all manner of dark spirit is hibernating in her belly. Burn, Holy Ghost. ransacked by your consuming fire. Holy Ghost fire, even burn spirit that's living in her vagina. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack her vagina by your consuming fire. Burn spirit that live in her uterus, in her womb, in her polypity, in all her organs, in the parts of her body, in her rectum. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack those areas by your consuming fire. Burn from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Burn all manner of objects, garments, jewelry that were placed in and on her body. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn those rings on her finger. Burn even crown around her neck. Burn that unholy garment of unrighteousness. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn every mark that was made in and on her body. Every piercing that was made in and on her body. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn that body covenant. Set ablaze. Set ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack her body by your consuming fire. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, continue to ransack her body. Baptize her body. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem, and purify her body in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, in the spirit realm, I take the scissors of God. I cut and detach Elizabeth from that ungodly covenant of family adoption witchcraft. I detach her from every relationship in the spirit realm that my father did not connect her to. I disconnect her. I disconnect her from the evil spirit husband, evil spirit wife, the evil spirit children, that entire evil spirit family. I disconnect her because the blood of Jesus disconnects her and sets her totally free. Even in the natural realm, every relationship my heavenly father did not connect Elizabeth to, I disconnect her because the blood of Jesus disconnects her and sets her totally free by his shed blood. Elizabeth, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you be totally free. Amen. Be free in your mind. Amen. Be free in your will.
Amen.
Be free in your emotions.
Amen. Amen.
Be free in your dreams, in your vision, in your businesses, and in your affairs, and be totally free in your body to serve and worship Lord. Him only will you serve and worship in Jesus' mighty name. Be free. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Now fill your daughter to overflow. Don't leave her vacant or void. Fill her to overflow with your spirit. Fill her mind, her will, her emotion, her vision, her dreams, her businesses, her affairs, and fill her body to overflow with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, I pray, Holy Ghost, go destroy every covenant, contract, agreement that was written in her name, her family name, on top of the earth, under the water, even in the heaven. Destroy those covenant contracts and agreements. Even the garments and the objects that was buried on top of the earth, under the earth, thrown in the water, carried up into the heaven, in her name, her family name, destroy those garments and objects. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Holy Ghost, even go in her house. Destroy all darkness and its hiding places. Go in every corner, crack, and crevice of the house and destroy darkness. Go in every room, every bedroom. Destroy darkness who was around the bed, under, over, the foot, the head, and the top of the bed, in between the sheets and the mattress. Destroy darkness. And all its hiding place, and the objects that is hidden in the house. Even go outside the house. Destroy doors that who was around the house, under and over the house, in the front yard, in the backyard. Destroy by your consuming fire. Thank you, Father, for protecting Elizabeth. Setting angels around her, protecting her, and placing her in the fiery bubble protection of the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord, for no harm shall come near her. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you. Amen, Sister Elizabeth. It's done. You are free.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Just that simple. Faith is simple. Faith is simply believe it. If you speak the word of God, the will of God, done on earth, he does in the heaven, you are free. That means those thieves are no longer in you. You're free now. Your will is free to make a decision. The mind is free to think the ways of God, the thoughts of God. Your emotions are free where you can act and react as the Holy Spirit. And your body is free to be the temple of the Holy Ghost. You are free. Amen. So, Sister Nisbet, as I was praying, did the Lord allow you to experience anything as I was praying?
I felt pains in my back and under my feet.
Mm-hmm. And they had to go. They gone. They gone. They try to leave pain so you can. And they will leave it now. They try to leave the pain so you can focus on the pain and thinking that you're not delivered. People, come on now. Demons are clever. That's why you have to hold on to your faith in God. Don't let nothing sway you away from God and believe in his word.
Okay.
His faith is not in what we see or what we feel. It's in what we know. He set us free. So the devil had to leave and take his pain with him. Now, there's a general pain that happens to the body to warn us that something is wrong. It's a general pain. But there is a demon spirit whose function or responsibility, and that's who it is. It's pain. It spends all of its days or nights or moments in pain, you see. And it will take advantage of us when we experience general pain. So that devil who was pain, who is pain, the Lord kicked it out. It's not in you. Not the demon pain. Right now, if you go outside and thump your toe, you're going to feel pain. That's a general pain. It lets you know that something just happened to your toe. You understand? That's a general pain. But then there's a demonic pain who loves to take advantage of when a person has a general pain. It'll jump in a person and make a person think it's a general pain. Well, God deliver you from that pain. You are free. Okay?
I'm praying.
Amen. Yeah, by faith in Jesus' name. And you
thank
keep
Jesus.
Raising him.
Thank Jesus.
You keep thanking him.
Yes, Father.
And if
yes, thank
devil,
thank
pain
you.
Try to come, whether
thank you, Jesus.
If the pain try to come, a spirit husband, whoever, you say no. Jesus Christ has set me free by faith. I receive my deliverance, and I'm free. And you start praising and thanking the Lord. Especially if you have dreams. Don't talk about those dreams. Forget about those dreams. Forget about that. All demonic dreams should not be relayed to another person unless you relay it to a servant of God who God's going to use to deliver you. That's different. But if God's not using that person to deliver you, then such demonic visions and dreams, you don't need to be meditating, thinking over, and talking about, because you magnify it and it gets stronger and bigger in your life. You forget about it, and you thank God for delivering you. Now, I'm talking to those who've been delivered. Now, if you ain't been delivered, you need to get delivered when you have such dreams. You get delivered from those dreams. So praise God. So, Sister Elizabeth, you know, if you have any more questions, just send me an email, and as soon as I'm available, I will respond to your email, okay?
Okay. Can I just ask you, thank you very much for what you, for the prayer. Thank you very much for the passion. Thank you very much for your attention. Can I just ask you one question?
You have to make it quick because I gave you a lot of time.
I'll make it quick. Can I receive prayer to receive the Holy Ghost? because I've not yet received the Holy Ghost.
What you need to do on my program, on my YouTube, I have a playlist, the Holy Spirit and His gift. And I would advise you to take your time to listen to it and also go to your Christian bookstore and order Kenneth Hagin. He's with the Lord now. Kenneth Hagin.
Take your time.
They can zoom through it. We messes up by zooming through it. Take your time. You deliver now. So I would advise you after you deliver to go back to it. Take your time and get your Bible and do a study on what the man of God is saying. That's what I did. And then listen to the teachings that I, the video teachings that I did on it. And then before you know it, then you get a whatever it is that is blocking you from receiving the baptism of the Holy Spirit, evidence of speaking in true tongues, it will be released. And before you know it, the Holy Spirit has come upon you.
Amen, amen. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
All right, that's how you do that. All right, praise God. All right, stay blessed now, okay? All right.
Thank you very much. Praise God.
You welcome. Praise the living God. All right, let's see, I have four more callers. So I'm going to bring on 2986. 2986.
Hello.
Okay, is this brother Darnard?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I love your voice. And you in Illinois, right?
No, I'm in Wisconsin, Racine, Wisconsin.
Oh, Wisconsin, right? My team is in Wisconsin. Illinois, okay. All right, brother. Well, thank you for you and Sister Elizabeth being obedient to the Holy Ghost in the long morning prayer, because the Lord told me that you two need to be delivered. And so I praise God that when I mentioned about a couple of you need to be delivered and to send me your phone number so I can have it on file. So when you call, I can see that you call, so I give you a call priority. You obey. So praise the living God. So first of all, I thank you for joining us on yesterday morning, Shalom morning prayer. It was a delight to hear a man's voice, a male voice, praying. That was a truly blessing. Amen.
Thanks, Lord.
So I know you love the Lord, Brother Bernard, and God definitely loves you. It's just that, just like me, He has some of you, but He just don't have all of you. You know, just like you, I love Him, but I thought with all my heart, which I did, the Lord said, you did, Terry, you love me with all your heart, but not with all your soul and all your body. Ain't that something? We'll say, well, I love the Lord with all my heart, but that's your spirit that loves the Lord. That's your spirit. And we worship, you worship, just as I did, you worship the Lord in your spirit. But the soul, mind, will, emotion, body, we could not give God those areas, because those demons that were residing, living there, were never confronted and commanded to come out. And that's why the Lord said, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. So, Brother Darnard, how long have you been serving the Lord? You've given your life to the Lord.
I've been serving the Lord off and on for over half of my life. I'm 52 years old, so I want to say a good 28 years.
And you heard yourself, you said off and on. And what was
off
the reason?
Off and on.
What was the reason for that off and on? Because the devil was still living in your soul realm, in your body, forcing you to do things contrary to the will of God, even contrary to your spirit. You knew those things were wrong, but it was like you just couldn't help doing it. And you can't, because you got someone on the inside forcing you to do contrary to the will of God. You do it. A lot of times you did wrong in tears, but you just couldn't help not doing it. And that all because there was never in a, that's why Jesus said, the harvest is great. but the labor, the workers are great, are many. The harvest is great, but the workers are few. Yeah. The harvest is great, and it is great, ready for the reaping. There's only a few workers. And then because they've never been delivered, because they're doing the same thing as sinners. They're practicing sin. That's why their best friend is a sinner. That's why, and I'm not talking to you, Bernard. I am not. The Holy Spirit may be, but I'm not. But I'm talking to those who are listening over the archive, listen live. That's why your best friend is a sinner. Because you are a sinner. Come on now. Darkness is only attracted to darkness. So if you tell me your best friend is a sinner, well, you just told me you are a sinner. Because darkness is not attracted to light. So this spirit wife, now you're aware of that spirit calling itself to be a female in the spirit realm, claiming to be your lover. Are you aware of it?
It comes I just recently was taught about deliverance. I always thought that the Lord would deliver me. I didn't know much about different spirits, and then all I knew was about the devil and about God.
About Satan and not the his troops that he have under his rulership, which were all those fallen angels. And the Lord, he do deliver, even through his servant. It's the Lord who delivers through his chosen servant. What you didn't know about was the delegated authority that God had given his body on earth, his servants on earth, in casting demons out of his children. That you didn't know about. You see? And that was what we was never taught about either. Because they taught us that once you give your heart to the Lord, everything about you is saved. When everything about you is not saved. So this spirit wife, as you heard me say many times so far, it entered you as a little boy, young boy, when you came aware of sex. That's when you would espouse Brother Denard, unknowingly. And I want you to share, no call out, no name, share what memory the Holy Ghost has brought to you about that molestation. You came to be aware of sex.
It's like when I was about 8 years old. I was sexually approached by family member. And Things happen that shouldn't happen. I mean, not me being willing. I was a child, but you know, it's very embarrassing and hurtful. Basically, you understand. I was took.
Well, that's when the spirit espoused itself to you. You saw the human being, but the true culprit was a spirit being in which you could not see, and that thing enter you to live in you and to be with you. And it dictated to you what it wanted you to do. And it were always things that was rebellious against not just your parents, but against the Lord Jesus Christ himself. And that thing had been living in you all this time. And it also opened doors for other spirits. The Lord wants us to bind the strong man, get rid of the strong man. And those spirits that depend on the leash of the strong man goes right behind the strong man because their strength will be gone. But God can set you free. That's the reason why he says short time now. But he wanted to do this a long time ago. He wanted to do it a long time ago, but seriously, like he said, harvest is great, but the workers are few. You'd be surprised of men of God's children who are afraid of devils. They wouldn't be much trying to cast a devil out. They're afraid of them. They don't believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord said, he shines, shall follow them that believe in my name, believe in me, and know who I am in them and who they are in me. They shall cast devils. They shall heal the sick. They shall raise the dead. They shall freedom. Give as they freely receive. Praise the living God. So Lord, since your time. So what's important, Brother Darnard, is that you is no longer living or practicing sin, living in obedience to the Lord, because it's not, devils are not going to go anywhere because they know their legal ground. They know sin is their legal right. Now we can sound holy and righteous. We can sound anointed, but it's not in the sound. It's in your life work, what you practice in life. You say, you will know them by their fruit. It's in what you do, how you act, how you react. So that's really important that we sin. When we sin, we ask the Father to forgive us. And we sin no more. But we don't practice sin. Now, we're not married. Can't be living with a woman, a man that's not your spouse. And you say you love the Lord. And are we going to get married? And no, the point is you're not married. You ain't got no business there. But we're going to get married. No, that's not your wife. That's not your husband. You are practicing sin. And again, this gives the enemy legal right to afflict upon that person whatsoever they want afflicted upon them. So it's important to close all doors of unrighteousness, all doors of sin, and sin no more. That's important. So my question, Brother Darnard, you're not a sinner. Is that correct? A sinner is someone who willfully practices sin. That is a sinner.
No, I don't willfully practice sin.
Right, willfully.
I love you know God. You do.
Right. Amen. You'll be surprised, men of God's children who are sinners, they willfully practice sin. Willfully. That means you know you're doing wrong, but you still choose to do that wrong. That means you are practicing sin. Now, the scripture said we all have sinned. That's past tense. And come short of the glory of God. And we have, but that's past tense. It don't mean that we all are sinners, which is presently we sin. We practice it. We willfully practice sin. We don't do that. We make a mistake. Oh, we repent and we sin no more. But if you keep making that same mistake, then you are willfully sinning. That's not a mistake. A mistake is a mistake. Now, I have made mistakes. I said, Lord, forgive me. I didn't know. I should not do that again. And I never did. That was a mistake. But if I do it again and again and again, well, that makes me a practicing sinner. And that gives them a legal right not to go anywhere. The Brother Darnard, you know you now want to be, you're free in your spirit, but you want to be free in your mind, your will and emotion. You don't want the thieves, the strangers, to be have any space in you. You want to be delivered from them, and God's going to set you free, okay?
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the living God. He has heard you. Amen. He's that answer. So I'm going to pray for you. And then I come from my spirit wife. And in the meantime, you just be freeing yourself. Be thanking the Lord for setting you totally free. Okay? Praise God. So, Father, in Jesus' name, thank you for my dear brother, Darnard. Now has come to be his time. It's time to fulfill your plan, your mission, your idea in his life, which will only bring glory to your Son, Jesus Christ. For your desire is to have all of him, spirit, soul, and body. There are those who are waiting on my brother to be delivered out of the kingdom of darkness to the marvelous light. And I thank you for preparing him as a true and honorable vessel for your use, because you are definitely his master. I ask you to give him more wisdom, revelation, understanding as to who he is in your Son Jesus and who Jesus is in him. Father, I speak concerning the doors of the enemy have closed off for my brother. And it is your will for those doors to be open. I speak my thoughts in Jesus' name, and I open those doors. And I also close every door that was never your will to be open, that the enemy opened. I close those doors and seal those doors with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Father, we just thank you for your loving mercy and grace, your faithfulness. And we thank you for your loving kindness and your patience. I thank you, Father, what you're about to do in your Son's life.
Yes.
I thank you, Lord. And I glorify you always. I thank you, Father, for not allowing my brother to continue to be in the condition he's in. You're looking down on him. You're seeing his love for you, but you also saw in his soul and body that you didn't have no dealings in those areas. And you refused to allow him to continue to go on this earth in that way as you did me. And I thank you for setting him to totally free, where he can truly now, when he hold up his hands, they will truly be holy hands, where he worships you spiritually and truthfully. And I thank you, Father, for your word, in which you said, whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you bind and you loose in the heaven. So on that note, spirit-wise, you have no legal right to remain in my brother. In the name of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you saw him on that cross, blood been shed for my brother, as well as all of us. And that is his legal right for you to come out of his mind. To pack your thing, gather your loads, and get out of his mind. Take sorrow with you. Take self-pity with you. Every spirit that is under your control, you gather around your waist and get out of his mind. Take your nasty, evil images and thoughts out of his mind. Pictures out of his mind. Memories out of his mind. Gap. Never, ever to return. But there is no vacancy. And you turn loose his will. Loose his will and get out. Count his emotions. Gather everything that belongs to you and get out of the emotion. Pack your loads, and also you vacate his body. You go where the Father commands you. Angels of the Most High God, grab them and take them where the Father commands them. Holy Ghost fire, burn. Do your most perfect work in ramshackle his mind, his will, his emotions, and his body of every unclean spirit that is trying to hold back. Burn them all up. Burn them, Holy Ghost. Burn in his mouth. Burn in his mouth. Burn in his nose. Burn in his eyes. Burn in his ears, up and down his throat, burn. Burn, go deep, deep down in his belly and burn. Burn all manner of spirit that is hibernating in his belly. Set them all ablaze. Burn even in his penis. Oh, burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, Holy Ghost. Set it ablaze, even in his rectum. Set it ablaze, Holy Ghost. Burn up and down his arms, his legs. Burn rings that were placed on his fingers, on his toes. Burn the necklace that were placed around his neck. Chains that were placed on his body. Burn all amount of shackles that were placed on his body. Burn all amount of marks that was made in and on his body. Piercing more images. Burn that body covenant. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack his body. Wash, rinse, clean, redeem. Purify and ransom his body. In and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, in the spirit realm, I take the scissors of God. I cut and I detach my brother Darnard from the ungodly covenant of idolatry and witchcraft. I detach him from the evil spirit marriage. I detach him from the evil spirit wife, evil spirit husband, those spirit children, the child spirit family. I detach him from every relationship in the spirit realm my Heavenly Father did not connect him to. I disconnect in Jesus' mighty name. Even in this natural realm, there are relationships my Heavenly Father did not connect him to. By faith in Jesus' name, I disconnect him from those relationships that my Father did not connect him to in Jesus' mighty name. Brother Darnard, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you'll be totally free to serve the Lord. Be free in your mind. Be free in your will. Be free in your emotions. Be free in your dreams, your visions, your business, and your fast. And be totally free in your body. Serve and worship the Lord. Him only will you serve in spirit and truth. Be free in Jesus' mighty name. Be free. Father, fill your son to overflow with your spirit. Fill his mind, his will, his emotion, and his body to overflow with your spirit, Father. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, I also speak, Holy Ghost, go and destroy every covenant, contract, and agreement that was written in his name, his family name, on top of the earth, under the earth, under water, and even in the heavens. Destroyed by your consuming fire. Destroy every garment, every object that was thrown on top of the earth, buried under the earth, thrown in the water, or carried up to the heavens, in his name, his family name, destroy those evil garments and options in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, go in Darnard's house. Destroy all darkness hiding places. Seek and destroy darkness in every corner, crack, and crevice of the house. Go in every room, every bedroom. Destroy darkness who was around the bed, under, over, front, the foot of the bed, on top of the bed, in between the sheets and the mattress, and destroy by your consuming fire. Destroy objects that is hidden in the house, under the house, in the house. Destroy by your consuming fire. Destroy darkness that who was around the house, under the house, and over the house, and even walk about in the front and the backyard. Destroy by your consuming fire. Thank you for placing my brother, fire protection of the Holy Ghost, so you make your minister flames of fire. Thank you, Father, for the angel who's always with him, protecting him. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Brother Darnard is born in Jesus' mighty name. So as I was praying, Holy Ghost fire prayer, what was you experiencing as I was praying?
I went back to thinking when I was listening to a gospel song, whereas it was saying something like, my life is not my own, to you I belong, I give myself.
Right.
I was thinking, I was singing to the Lord, and the Lord, the Spirit told me then, when are you going to get yours? Jesus gave his for you, when are you going to get yours?
Amen.
Yeah.
It's done.
And that's it.
Grace
it's done.
That's it.
It's
done. Praise the living God.
Oh,
it's done for you.
I love the Lord. I'm going to serve the Lord if I...
Amen. Amen. He calls you home. The Lord himself calls you home. Amen. Glory to his holy name. And you share, Brother Denai, you share your testimony with others. You know, Holy Spirit is going to lead you to go into detail. You go into those details. There's a reason. He wants you to go into those details with that pearl. Some people need to hear your details.
Please.
They'll know that the same God who saved and set you free will also save and set them free. So you praise, you worship him, and you know by faith Jesus has set you free.
Yes,
you don't have to tolerate the devil's abuse. When he comes trying to show up, knocking on the wall, coming into your dreams, trying to plant thoughts into your mind. You rebuke it in Jesus' name. Reject it in Jesus' name. And you look up to your Heavenly Father and you thank him for setting you totally free. You praise and you worship him in spirit and truth. And as you do that, you are resisting the devil. And the devil will be running from you. Amen. It's done in Jesus' name.
Hey,
if you have any further questions, just feel free to
I just want to say quickly, you know, the Spirit just told me that. Thank you, Jesus. Continue, please. Anything further, follow your. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
You said anything further?
Could you say that a little louder?
I'm sorry. I was listening to you, but the Spirit of God has told me he got me. You know, so I'm gonna continue by following up with your programs and continuing Shalon and continue to read and search out, and then
Amen.
I have a great friend and fiance that's church bound.
Amen.
Lord, serve the Lord. So she's been not so much riding me, but correcting me and, you know, pulling me closer and telling me things about deliverance and things which caused me to come to your line. I appreciate,
Amen.
You know, you praying for
Amen.
Me and rebuking these demons. I truly believe they gone from this day forth. I'm going to put all my trust and focus on the Lord and stay in the Word
Amen.
And draw back near to God.
Amen, man. And I love it when the Holy Spirit said, I got you. I mean,
he
don't just got
That's
your spirit,
he
got your soul and your body. I'm telling you, the Lord told me that. He said, I have some of you, Terry, but I don't have all of you. And I was so confused. And then when that demon came out of me, I understood. He did not have my soul, my mind, my will, emotion, my body. He just had my spirit. Now the Holy Spirit said, I got you. I got all of you now. I got all of you. Now you can act and react like the Holy Spirit, the fruit of the Holy Spirit. That is your actions and your reaction is the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
Mm.
You're such a peaceful person, full of joy, kindness, and patience towards a person, no matter how they treat you. That's how the Holy Spirit acts and reacts. Now, if you act contrary to that, and that tells who's in you. Amen.
The Spirit just told me I have to be humble and forgiving. I got some things I hadn't let go, but I talked about it this morning. And through the grace of God, a lot of it was, it was like dealt with. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, I had trust issues with my mom and situations like that. And, it come out real ugly to a good friend of mine, and it led him to believe, well, if you have them type of feelings towards your mom and you won't release them or forgive them, how are you going to go on further to be able, when you see this in life, you know, how you going to deal with it? Is it going to take you back to that hating spot, or can you forgive and move on and, you know, just pray for the situation that might be at hand and not take it personal on yourself again? So, I mean, the Lord is working with me in a lot of ways, but I feel great right now. I feel like I've been
released. Because now you're able to release your mom, forgive your mom. You need to go back and ask your mom to forgive you for your action and your reaction, and let her know that you are a new person now in Christ, because he delivered you. He delivered you from,
amen.
And be again in detail. Come on, dear heart, get in detail. See, he delivered me from demons living in my mind, will, emotion, body. And that's the reason why I acted and reacted the way that I did, because they controlled me. Come on now, dear heart. Get in detail, because people need to hear this so that they too would know, oh, that's the reason why I act and react that way. And the mama would say, forgive me, son, because I was just as much as blamed as you. Where this lady? I want to get delivered, too. I want to be saved. Come on, dear heart. We need to get into details now. You just don't merely tell the person, I'm saved now. I'm delivered now. You saved from what? You delivered from who? Get in detail. People need to hear details.
I'm saved from that lusting spirit. I'm saved from that lying spirit. I'm saved from that cheating spirit. Okay, that lusting spirit where I may see a woman and might want to get with her in a sexual manner, and knowing that this is not my wife, I'm saved from that. You know, I'm saved from.
He delivered me. Turn around and deliver me. Not just say I'm delivered. He cast that spirit out of me.
I'm delivered. I'm saved from that lying spirit where I feel the need to not be honest and tell a person a quick one instead of telling them the truth or maybe how I feel. I don't want to do this. You know, I'm saved from that thievery spirit where sometimes you understand me or ain't nobody seeing me. I can get this. I'm saved from a lot of things that ain't of the Lord, and I thank you. And I can go ahead on and confess, you know, I'm saved from, you know, just I'm saved. You know, God has blessed me. I'm saved. I'm delivered. I'm saved. And
I give God wants to deliver them.
Thank you. Thank you. And I want everybody to know that God is real. God will deliver you. God loves you. God loves you very much. You know, he saved me. He'll save you.
Amen.
And like the Evangelist King said, we come from a long ground thinking we serving God, but all the time we gave God our fullest. I'm so happy today that I got delivered. I'm saying,
amen. Thank
God
you,
is here.
Thank you, Lord. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Amen, my brother. And you continue to share that testimony. And again, if you have any further questions, feel free to email me. As soon as I'm available, I will respond, okay? Amen.
Yes, ma'am.
But stay blessed, amen. Okay?
Amen. Yes, ma'am. And thank you very much. Thank the Lord. First of
you
all, thank the Lord.
Lord.
Thank everybody that's out there listening, and that Evangelist King,
amen.
Thank you very much. Continue to do what you're doing, the work of God. God has got something going on
amen.
In you that's wonderful. God bless
amen.
You. We
amen.
Love you. We look forward
you
know, to hearing
you.
From you, talking
amen.
To you.
Amen.
Shalom.
Amen. All right, Baba.
Amen.
Praise the living God. Now I'm going to bring on Ned, who's been holding for a while, 6607. But I believe there was a calling. You were hanging on longer than 6607, but you hung up and you called back. So when you hang up and call back, it puts you on a different hold time. So I advise you, if you've been hanging on a long time, just keep on hanging on. Because if you hang up and call back, it'll put you on a different hold time. So when I look on the hold time, then I won't bring you on, because it showed me you've been holding on a less time. So since 6607, been hanging on. Now, also now for, I only got about 40 minutes. So 3318 and 9362, since you've been holding on, I will go ahead and do, I'm going to do a second. Hold up for a second, everybody. Go to mommy. I'm going to go ahead and do a second episode for today. So if I don't get to 3318-9362-3871, and I'm going to write your numbers down. And if I don't get to you, hold on, I'm writing your number down. 3871. So that's 3318. That's the last four digits of the number you're calling for. 3318-9362-3871. If I don't get to you on this episode, well, I'm going to do a second episode for today. After this episode, it'll be 4 p.m., so it'll be 4:30 p.m., and it's Eastern Standard Time. So it'll be, after I hang up, it'll be 30 more minutes. I have to give Blog Talk Radio that break, then I can create, and I can come on another episode. So just go to radio.evangelistking.me and click on next upcoming episode, or you can call the number back at 4:30 p.m. for part two for Calling Deliverance Live Radio, July 4th, 18. Because I want to go ahead and get your deliverance in today. 3318-9362-3871. I give you a call priority. Because like I said, I'm going to have about 37 minutes to bring on 6607. Okay? All right. So, 6607. What's your first name and the state you're calling from?
Hi, Evangelist King. This is Martina from Wisconsin.
Oh, this is Martina. Now, Martina, you know you're a return caller.
I originally was just on here to listen to Darnard's Deliverance because that's my fiance and whatnot. But while I'm on here, I wanted to just ask a question because, you know, I heard the part about not living with someone who's not your spouse. And I don't think I fully understood that. I knew about not sleeping in the same bed, but I thought because we weren't doing that it was okay. But I heard that it's not even okay to live in the same place. And my question was, you know, I believe the Lord, I know that the Lord delivered me yesterday via the Shalom morning prayer. And it was just like when we came back to the house, later on at the house, it's like something, it's like I changed a little bit, like I just remember getting agitated, and I was worshiping. And I just started feeling agitation and irritated. And he was in there worshiping and spending his time with the Lord. I was in the opposite, you know.
Well,
the other
thing I understand. Hello, Martina. You went mighty fast on me. So I have to make sure I understand. Now, did I hear correctly that you are Darnard's fiancée?
Yes, ma'am.
Did I hear that correctly? So you are the one who is Darnard's fiancée. And you two are living in the same house.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, have you
I thought because we weren't laying in the same, I knew we couldn't sleep in the same bed. And I thought,
Hold up, Martinka, you go so fast. Hold up. So you two are living in the same house. So have y'all two been intimate with each other in that house?
No, not physical penetration. No penetration.
I ain't say no penetration. Now, you know me by now. That's why you word it that way. You don't have to be no penetration. The fondling, the kissing, as though you husband and wife.
Yes, ma'am. And I was telling him when we're not married, we can't kiss on the lips.
Okay.
And he really didn't understand that.
Martina, I need you to hush because you go so fast. But you really have to watch this yourself because the enemy tried to get you to justify your actions. Okay? You know truth. Okay, so you two were acting as though you were married. But then when Shalom won the prayer, you fell under conviction. You fell under conviction because the Holy Spirit been telling you that you were living in sin. It was wrong. Okay? So now you two are still living in the same house.
Yes, ma'am. When I came there, I came from a shelter, and basically we made the decision for me to move in, but I had said, you know, we can't, basically, we live together. Evangelist came.
Yeah, see, y'all don't have to ask the question. See, you have to be careful. The enemy try to get you to try to justify your wrong actions, okay? So after Shalom went to prayer, you became agitated. You became agitated because you know truth. Now, Brother Darnard, he's blind. He was really blind. Even though he knows truth, but according to this whole situation, he's just blind. But God was really holding you responsible because you know truth. Okay. Now he's delivered. He delivered. He set free. So you two know you're not married. Okay.
All right.
So you two gonna have to get together, and somebody is gonna have to go because you're not married. Mm-hmm. The Lord says, "Shun." You hear me say this many times. Shun the very appearance of evil. You know,
yes,
when
yes.
people look at you two being together, they automatically think that you two are married. Automatically.
Right.
You know, if you're gonna go try to share your testimony with Jesus Christ, they're gonna turn. They're gonna say, like the sons of Sceva. Like the devil told some of Skip, who do you think you are? You in a house, or you in a house with a man or woman, that's not your spouse. Okay? I knew at the moment you needed a place to stay. That's how the devil got you, because you needed a place to stay. And I know the Holy Spirit told you to stay at that shelter. Regardless of how things were going, it was best to stay there than to move in a house with a man that you're not married to, but you chose to go. And there ain't no way you're going to live in a house with a man you ain't married to. And that man, especially if not your relative, and that man is not a bad-looking man. And the way Brother Bernard sounds, he's not a bad-looking man. Ain't no way you can say you can move in that house and nothing's going to happen. Just no way. The Lord says, shun the very appearance of evil. So you two need to get together. You either need to quickly go ahead and get married. I don't know his situation, if he ever been married and never divorced or not, and that can hold up the marriage. But if he never been married, you need to quickly go ahead and get married.
Yeah, I'm in charge of buying the marriage certificate, and he did the ring. So how it goes is it takes 5 days. So I would be able to go pay it on. The earliest would be tomorrow, and then it would take 5 days. And then once you get it, you know, you go and pick a judge or a pastor, unless you have a pastor. And then however long that date is, I don't know how the earliest they would do it. So that's pretty much the process.
Now, do he have friends and relatives? And even though that's his house, but you got children.
Yeah, that's his house.
So it's going to be more difficult for you to find a place. Do he have friends and relatives that maybe he can ask to stay with them for those 5 days? And then y'all go ahead and get married.
I know for sure he has a cousin here. I know he's not originally from here.
But talk to him about that.
Okay.
Talk to him about it, if he could do that. If he really truly loved you and the children, he would understand, he would do that. Because the longer you two stay in that house together as though you're married, you're sinning, because that is spirit. It don't matter if you're not sleeping together. There's still a sin. That's the reason why you got agitated. And you need deliverance again. Because I'm telling you, dear heart, don't think you can lay with the devil and not get up with the devil in you. Why do you think you got agitated? That spirit in you got agitated. You listened to Shalom morning prayer.
Because he wasn't doing nothing but worshiping. It was later on that night, though. I was fine all day. It's like I was in peace. And, you know, I went to court concerning Joy, and they turned around and basically about to give her visitation at her home without supervision. She just won that starting next Saturday. So I already was kind of, my mind wasn't, you know, but I made that decision. I'm not going to turn my back on God. I'm going to keep trusting in him. You know, I got a little, he gave me peace in that. And later on when I went back to the house and I was worshiping and I was reading the word, I suggested that he do the same. And he came in from outside with Joy. Once he started doing the same, next thing I know, I just started feeling irritated and agitated. I knew something wasn't right. There's no reason I should have been feeling like that.
Yeah, because that spirit is in you. That's why the Lord said he's looking on you as at fault and not him, because he was blinded and you was not. You went in with your eyes wide open. And that's the reason why, because you were so agitated because that spirit is in you. You know, that spirit just didn't get in you. That spirit got in you a while back. Let me ask you this. This always been a concern. Did you ever go back and sleep with your, and I'm going to say, with your ex? Did you ever do that?
No, ma'am. What happened was, when I was at that shelter, I did meet this female, and we end up, like, dating, basically.
Now, did you ever kiss her?
Not my ex, no, not my ex.
So
no, he was at that shelter about six months ago.
Your ex never kissed you.
I haven't not been in physical contact with my ex, Lori, the one I left Milwaukee. I don't even see her. I drop him off at visitation. It's a third party. I don't even see her.
Okay.
So it wasn't my ex. It was this girl I met at the shelter, and I was still demonized. And, you know, I had already felt like, you know, this when you was going through your sickness and stuff, but, we're still having shalom prayer, though, then, at that time. This was about in February.
Yeah, we were having shalom prayer, and I felt like you was involved with a female, and I thought maybe it was your ex.
No, it was this lady at the
the lady at the shelter.
That's me.
Okay, so it wasn't the ex.
We both did. You know, we both did.
And you fell into that scene. You fell into that scene. Mm-hmm. You needed deliverance then. Because every time I turned around, I was receiving your email. Man, King, I'll deliver today. I know the Lord delivered me. Because 2 days later, or maybe a week later, Man, King, I'm delivered. God delivered me today. I said, oh, God, what is my thing of doing?
Right, it was like it wasn't staying. Like, it seemed like as soon as I was getting delivered.
It wasn't God's fault, Martina. You said it like it was God's fault. Now, that was your fault. First of all, you didn't do what he told you to do. That's where you messed up, Martina.
I thought I had
an
open door that maybe I didn't know about, and therefore every time I would get cleansed, that spirit would come back because I hadn't closed the door. Like, I hadn't asked for forgiveness or something, or it was a door that was open.
No. That devil came back because you failed to do what God told you to do. God never told you to move out of that place and go into a shelter. He told you to be saving money aside to move out of that apartment complex, because that apartment complex was demonized. As long as you stayed in there, you will be in experience those heavy demonic attacks, because the landlord, the owner of the land, worships Satan. That's what God told you to do. He didn't tell you to.
I thought I heard from the Lord. I literally heard this. I heard, pack your stuff, go to the shelter. And then I said, well, how am I going to do this, blah, blah, blah. I heard, pack your stuff.
But the point of it is, Matisse, God already told you what to do. So when that second voice came in, pack, go to the shelter, you should have said, hold up. This is not what you told me to do initially. You told me to save up my money to move out of here. Because you got little children that need a steady place to stay, not in an unstable home like a shelter. So you should have questioned that.
That's part of what they said in court. That's part of what they said in court, too, right?
Yeah. That's why that girl ended up getting those visitation, unsupervised visitation rights, because you look to be unstable. That's why she did it. And that's the reason why the demon told you to do it, because he wanted her to get the visitation right. Because I told you what the enemy planned for your little baby. God wants to make him a homosexual. But mama got to get right. When you get right, get delivered.
I was trying my best, though. I try. I don't want nothing to happen to him.
You got to hearken to the voice of the Lord. You got to hearken to the voice of the Lord. Not hearken to all these other voices. I mean, women tell you you got children. You have to save up your money to move. So you have that stable home for your children. So when the other voice came, you were talking about pack and go. And you have no money. The only place you're going to the shelter. And that's not a stable place. Right there, that's not God. And see, and with you, you always email me after the fact. Not before the fact, but always after you made that decision. That was when you always would email me, Evangelist King, what should I do? Well, you should have emailed me before you made that decision. But what you do now, Martina, you repent. You can't change it. You repent, ask the Lord to forgive you. Okay? Yeah. Also, you obey the instruction of the Lord. You talk with Brother Darnard and ask him if he has family, friend that he can, you know, maybe stay with for 5 days until your marriage license come through. And you two go ahead and get married. So when he come back into the home, you two would be married and well-pleasing in the eyes of God. And the good thing about it, he gave it someone who loved the Lord, and he's and he him too is delivered. So he gave you someone to help you to fight in this spiritual battle. But first thing must come first. First thing must come first. You obey God's instruction. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
That's what you do. That's what you do. And then I advise you and him when I post this session. It would be Calling Deliverance Live Radio, July 4th, 2018, Part 1. Go back and listen to it. Go back and listen to it. I'm going to pray for you, and then I'm gonna speak a disconnect, because I know those spirits got back in. Ain't no way that you can delve in sin. And demons are not going to drop, not going to jump back in you. And there just ain't no way. So you are contaminated, spiritually contaminated. Okay? Martina?
Yes, Evangelist King. It's just that I'm at this park. I mean, I'm in the car. Denard came. He done came, and he got Jory. But I'm trying to let him know I'm just going to drive off because there's just too many people at this park, and I don't want the enemy trying to distract me.
Okay. All right.
So I'm just
going to
drive on. I'm thinking of just let me tell him real quick.
So everybody who listens to the archive, we must obey God's instructions precisely, because if we don't precisely obey God's instruction. If we call ourselves trying to talk to God, He's not going
to
talk back to
us. So let me, I'm going to go to the lake or something where I won't be distracted.
He's not going to talk back to us because He already told us what to do. And then that's when the enemy is going to come in with his voice, disguise himself as the Holy Spirit. When it's a false Holy Spirit, it's going to mention a lie to you to drag you deeper in sin. So we have to obey God's instructions. Instructions that I give you, they are not my instructions. They are the Holy Ghost's instructions, Jesus Christ's instructions. The devil say, you don't have to obey her. No, it's not me, it's him.
I'm on my way to... No, I'm just going to go down to the lake and just hope that God can meet me.
Thank you.
I'm on my prayer, Evangelist Kim.
Okay.
I'm drive down some car right here.
Here we are now, because I only got about 18 minutes.
Okay, I'm ready, Avengers King.
Okay. Now, brother Darnard, is he sitting right there beside you in the car?
No, ma'am. He stayed at the park with Jory.
Well, he stayed at the park with your little boy, okay, because I was going to get him to do something. So I noticed when I was doing his deliverance, I felt like there was confession he had to make by living with a woman that wasn't his wife. So I tried to put it as politely as I could. But how the devil deceived him was saying, was thinking that you two was not intimate together, no longer. So therefore, that was not a sin. So since he wouldn't confess to it, the Lord had you to come right around to confess it so that door could be closed. Because if you hadn't confessed to it, he would have ended right back in sin. Okay? Now, I know I felt it strongly. The Lord didn't want me to confess it for him. He had to confess it. So that's why I could not put it politely the way that I put it. But I'm going to pray for you, Martina. And then I'm going to speak disconnection from that spirit of deception, which includes spirit husband, spirit wife, and other spirits. But altogether, they are spirits of deception. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your dear daughter, actually my dear daughter too, Martina. Martina has been following you through me for a mighty long time. You know, there's some children. Even in the natural, we have children. They have different personalities. Some, we have to give more attention than others. And Martina seemed to be one of the children you have given me that require more attention. And I thank you, Father, that I did not give up on her. She did not give up on you. And you have not given up on us. I thank you, Father, that for what you're about to do in her life, to turn her life around. I thank you for sending her some help. You know, the help that she has, you know, the way it started out might not be in your will, but what the devil meant for harm, you're going to turn this situation around. And I thank you, Father, for Martina. And I thank you for Brother Darnard in admitting to their wrongdoing and their shortcomings. And you have truly forgiven them. And I ask you, Father, to continue to give them wisdom in this current matter, this current situation, in what they should, what they should not do. And I thank you for keeping them and keeping the children as well. And I thank you, Father, for reversing that judge decision in granting that woman unsupervised visit to her son. Father, I thank you for supernatural, they're just reversing it. And I thank you, Father, for that plan and purpose the enemy have for her son. I speak my thought in Jesus' name, and I destroy those plans and purposes and the idea that the enemy have for her little boy, her son. I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Father, for what you're about to do in my teen life. And freeing her once again. Because only you, Father, know that just when you look down on Martina in her heart, in her soul, in her mind, her will, emotion, in her body, and there'll be any unclean thing in her, I thank you, Father, for ridding her from it. But that is not her will, and that is not your will, Father. Deliver her from these spirits of deception, deceptive spirit. Father, I thank you for deafening her ears to the voice of the stranger in which she will only hear and know your voice, Father. And I thank you, Father, that you said whosoever that you join together, no one can come between it. And I thank you, Father, again, for handling this situation and giving them wisdom and insight into handling this situation, Father, in Jesus' name. So there will be many that you're going to draw to this day's program that's in the same predicament. And I thank you, Father, for giving them the wisdom to handle that situation, in which the situation would be pleasing in your, not in their eyesight, but in your eyesight, Father, in Jesus' name. So again, I thank you that you said whatsoever I bind and loose on this earth, you bind and you loose in the heaven. So on that note, spirit of deception, in the name of Jesus, I command you. I know you in there. There's just no way Martina participated in your affairs and you did not enter her. That's the reason why she committed that sin against our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You can be quiet all you want to, but I know you in there. And the spirit of the living God commands you to cut her mind. Loose her mind. Spirit husband, loose her mind. Cut. Gather all your things. Get out. Gather her mind. Turn loose her emotion. Cut her emotion. Gather every spirit that belongs to you. Bind them around your waist and get out. Loose her will. Loose it. And come out of her body. Out of her body. Come out. All of you, come out. You never, ever, ever to return in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, fire, burn. Burn every spirit that's trying to cling and hold on to Martina in her mind. Burn all that is not of you in her mind. Burn every thought, conscious, memory, and the conscious and subconscious of her mind. Instead of a blaze, every picture, every image in her mind, and set them ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn. Set them ablaze. Just ransacker mind. Ransacker will. Ransacker emotion. Every spirit that try to hold back in her emotion, they don't sound, act, react like you. Set them ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn even in her eyes. Burn every spirit that comes up and looks out through the window of her eyes. Set them ablaze. Burn, Holy Ghost. Ransack her eyes. Ransack her mouth. Burn all unfiltiness that's in her mouth. All manner of darkness living in her mouth, even in her nose, even in her ears. Burn even up and down her throat. Burn even deep down in her belly. Go deep, deep down in her belly. Burn, Holy Ghost. All manner of spirit that's hibernating in her belly, even in her vagina, in her rectum. Burn, Holy Ghost. Up and down her back, up and down her arms and legs, her chest, her breast. Burn rings on her fingers, toes, unholy, unrighteous garments. Burn. Even crown on her head. Holy Ghost, fire. Baptize her body. Rinse her body. Clean, redeem, purify. And ransom her body in and with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, in the spirit realm, I take God's seal. I disconnect my demon from every relationship in the spirit realm.
Yes,
my Heavenly Father did not connect her to, I disconnect her. The evil spirit husband, evil spirit wife, the evil spirit children, the entire evil spirit family, I even disconnect her from every covenant contract and agreement. In the spirit realm, my father did not connect to. Even in the natural realm, relationships, my father did not connect her to. I did connect her from those relationships.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name. Father, fill your daughter again with your spirit. Fill her mind, her will, her emotions, her dreams, her vision, business affairs with your spirit, Father. And fill her body to overflow with your spirit. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you for keeping the children. Do your inner cleaning work, even in her children, who have heard things they shouldn't have heard, seen things they shouldn't have seen, spoken things they shouldn't have spoken. Deliver them, Lord. Ransack their body. Ransack their mind, their will, and their emotions. Clean them up, Father. Fill them with your spirit. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You be free. Be free to serve the Lord your God. And sin no more, the Lord says. Least a worse thing will happen to you. Do you hear me, Martina? Sin no more, the Lord says. Least a worse thing will happen to you. Be free in your mind. Be free in your will. Be free in your emotions. Be free in your businesses, in your affairs, in your dreams, in your vision. Be totally free in your body to serve and worship the Lord.
Lord.
Only will you serve in spirit and truth. Be free in Jesus. Martina, did you hear the voice of the Lord? He said, sin no more. Least a worst thing will happen to you. You know truth. You're not a babe in Christ Jesus. He said, sin no more. Do you hear him, Montaigne?
Yes, Lord. Yes, Avengers King.
Well, you heard the voice of the Lord.
I just really need clarity on this, Avengers King. I don't know.
Ain't no clarity. You sin. The clarity is you sin no more.
I know, but my thing was like the people, please. I don't know exactly what, like say somebody looking at me and I'm walking.
Don't worry about that, Martina. Martina.
Is that people, please? Martina. I don't know what.
Martina.
Yes.
You hearken to the voice of the Lord. You keep your focus on the voice of the Lord, the word of the Lord. He said, sin no more. You don't put your mind on people. That's an excuse. You hearken to the voice of the Lord. You know right from wrong. You're not a babe. Right now, I don't know your daughter. She's 13 years old.
Almost.
Your
oldest
daughter.
In November, yes, yeah, she'll be 13.
Almost 13 years old. She know right from wrong. But when you tell her to do what's right, you expect her to hearken to your voice to do what is right. She don't come bringing up the wrong. You can tell her to shut up. You do what is right. You know right from wrong. Choose what is right. And that's what the Lord is telling you to do. You know right from wrong. You choose what is right. You can't keep trampling the law under your feet. That is dangerous, Martina. You end up having a reprobated mind. Reprobated mind is a mind that is double-minded, unstable in all its ways, confused, don't know which way to go, and you're heading toward that direction. That's because you keep trampling the goodness of God under your feet. The Lord said, he's forgiven you. Now sin no more. Do what is right. You know what is right to do. No one has to tell you. So you hearken to the voice of the Lord, what he has told you to do. That is what you do. Now, those of you who heard me, I had to get stern because it was that devil that tried to get back in just that quick. That wasn't Martina. That was that demon trying to get back in just that quick. And so I had to get stern at the devil, not stern at Martina. Martina just had to hear it, to wake her up, to let her realize who is that is using you to speak what you're speaking concerning the people pleaser. That wasn't the Holy Ghost. That was the spirit of rebellion. Accept that spirit, trying to get back in. Understand, Martina?
Yes.
That's what you do. So again, you know, you discuss that matter with Brother Darnard, and God will give y'all wisdom and get married as soon as you can. Soon as you can. So you can be well pleasing in the sight of God. Not well pleasing in the sight of people. You never be well pleasing in the sight of people, but well pleasing in the sight of God. Because you're married. Right. So my program is about to end, and I need to close out. So remember, those of you, let me ask you right quickly, make it fast, my thing. Did you express anything as I was praying the five prayers?
I was like kind of rocking, kind of moving back and forth. I was hunched over so I could focus, so I wouldn't be distracted. Also, like when you were saying, like I know you in there, you know, stuff like that. Like I felt like I wanted to laugh, like I was smiling.
Yeah, there's that demon. That wasn't you. It was those demons because they knew I was in there. They're trying, but it tends to be very quiet. The dude deceived the callers and thinking that they're not in there. When they were in there, but they out now.
Thank you, Lord. They out now. They gone. Amen. Amen. They were trying to say, like, oh,
amen,
she got.
Amen. All right, my program about to end, Martina. So keep me posted. Send me an email if you and Brother Darnard have any more questions, okay?
Okay, thank you, Evangelist King. God bless you.
You're welcome. Okay, praise God. Praise the living God. All right, so I see that 331-8-3871 and also 9362. They hung up, but I have instructed that you call back. I'm going to go ahead and do a second episode in 30 minutes. So it'll be 4:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So remember, it's 30 minutes. It's 4 o'clock now, almost 4 o'clock. So it'll be 4:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So if in 30 minutes, just call back, and I'll bring you on, give you priority in doing your session today. So praise the living God. So again, it's going to be a call-in deliverance live radio for July 4th, 2018, part 2 in 30 minutes, which is 4:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can call the guest number 929-477-4106. Go to the website, radio.evangelistking.me, and see the next upcoming episode for Praise the Living God. So remember to schedule deliverance sessions. They are held every Wednesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Okay? And you go to the website, radio.evangelistking.me. Or you can call in guest number 929-477-4106. And upon the leading of the Holy Spirit, if I have a lot of callers, I go ahead and do a second episode for that day. It's like I'm going to do today. Okay? All right. Talk to you later. Make sure you call back in. Shalom.
The Starlight Lounge presents An Evening with the Progressive Box.
Oh, what a great audience. Let's dim the lights for this next one. Nope, too much. Ah, there it is. Gotta get things just right. Like Progressive's Name Your Price tool. Tell us what you want to pay, and we help you find coverage options that fit your budget. And now, the mood is right. Wait, the lights are back on again. Trudy, can you? And now it's completely dark.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.